is all. Lord, we have confidence in you. Anytime, any day, we have confidence in you. Lord, we have confidence in you. Savior, Lord, we have confidence in you. Anytime, oh, every day, we have confidence in you. Almighty Father, Almighty Redeemer, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We thank you for such a beautiful day like this you have given unto us. We thank you for making it possible for us to gather from east to west, from north to south. Lord, we have come this morning to show gratitude unto you, to say thank you for your faithfulness, to say thank you for your kindness, to say thank you for everything you have done for us. We want to thank you for how you have preserved us to another day like this. Daddy, here we are in your presence. Daddy, we are grateful for the life you have given unto us. What shall we say unto you? We come to say thank you this morning. Lord, we pray this morning, anywhere we have sinned against you, that we make our prayer not to be answered this morning. Lord, I ask upon mercy upon our life. Lord, mercy upon our soul. Mercy upon us, my Father. Mercy upon all the entire member of this group. Holy Spirit, as we have come to you this morning, you will have your way in our life. Lord, you will take your place in our life. Lord, you will take your place this morning. These few minutes we are going to spend with you, may these minutes, may they not be in vain in our life. Holy Spirit of the Lord, do that which, oh Lord, my Father, that which you have determined to do in our life. Holy Spirit, we have come to take the breakfast with you. We have come to take the breakfast for our Father before we go out. Holy Spirit, give us the breakfast we needed, so that at the end of this morning program, Lord, the heart of your children will fill with joy. Lord, I silence every distraction right now. I hold them bound, every distraction from the pit of hell. Lord, I hold them standing now. In the name of Jesus, God, connect us now to the angels in heaven. We want to be connected. We want to be connected to the choir in heaven. Holy Spirit, because we don't know how to sing, we don't know how to praise you. But when we connected to the choirs in heaven, because there are special choirs in heaven, blessed Lord, eternal Father, immortal God, invisible God, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and Omega, the battle has, the one that has the solution for every problem, mighty man in battle, as we sing unto you, I ask you this morning, you roll away stones, my Father. As we sing unto you, you roll away sickness. As we sing unto you, you roll away, my Father, troubles of life. Lord, as we praise your name this morning, your presence will come down and take over upon your children, that at the end, your name will be glorified. Lord, let this morning be a special morning. Oh, my Father, let this morning, Lord, let it be a morning that people will say, I don't know that today's morning like this. Thank God that I didn't miss the program of this morning. Immortal God. Holy Ghost, I say, take heart now. Take charge upon every heart that connected to this program. Holy Ghost, take primary control now. for you are worthy to be praised. For in Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord. Please, you just look around. If there is the person, somebody that's supposed to be connected, is not connected, help that person so that that person can be on the program this morning. We are here, oh Father. We are here, oh Son. Holy Spirit, we are here. Come and take control. We are here, oh Father. We are here, oh Son. Holy Spirit, we are here. Come and take control. We are here, O Manuel. We are here, O Son. Holy Ghost, we are here. Come and take control. We are here, O Daddy. We are here, O Son. Holy Ghost, we are here. Come and take control. We are here, O Manuel. We are here, O Son. Holy Spirit, we are here. Take control. We are here, O Manuel. We are here, O Jesus. Holy Spirit, we are here. Come and take control. We are here for you, Lord. We are here for you. Holy man, we are here. Come and take control. We are here for you, Lord. We are here for you. Holy Spirit, we are here. Come and take control. We are here, O Daddy. We Son, Holy Spirit, we are here. Come and take control. We are here for you, Lord. We are here for you, Holy Spirit. We are here. Come and take control. Adonai, we worship you. Son of God, you are so good. Almighty Father, is forevermore. Adonai, Adonai, we worship you. We worship you, Lord, Son of God, Son of God. You are so good. You are so good, Almighty Father. Sister Bosse, call Sister Gladys to connect you. Sister Bosse, call Sister Gladys to connect you. Minion is forevermore. Hallelujah. Zion. Alleluia. Alleluia. Yes, Lord. Alleluia. 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 Oh, alleluia. Yes, Lord, alleluia, 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 oh, alleluia, alleluia, oh, yes, my Father, alleluia. Alleluia, 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 oh, alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 oh, alleluia, alleluia, yes, Daddy, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia. Lord of mercy, oh Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, oh Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, oh Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, oh yes, Lord, oh Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, Lord, I love you, oh Lord, I love you, Lord, I love you, oh Lord, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, I love you, Lord, we love you, Lord, we love, Lord, we love you, Lord, we love you, Lord, we love you, Lord, we love you. Love you, Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Oh, Lord, Lord, I love you. Oh Lord, I love you. Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Adonai, we love you. Lord, we love you. Oh Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Oh Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Brethren, why can't you begin to thank the Lord? Why can't you begin to reverence His name? Why can't you begin to adore Him? Why can't you begin to sing hallelujah to Him? Why can't you begin to say, Lord, I thank you for this morning? Why can't you begin to worship Him? Why can't you begin to praise His name for making it possible for you to be alive? Why can't you begin to thank Him because He's the one that ruled the world? Why can't you begin to appreciate Him because He's the Alpha and Omega? Why can't you begin to bless His name because beside Him there is no one? Why can't you begin to thank Him because He's the Rock of Ages, He's the Lion of the tribe of Judah, He's the great God, He's the Alpha and Omega, He's the only one that have the final say upon your life? Why can't you begin to say, Lord, I thank you because I'm alive. Thank you for counting me among the living. Thank you for making it possible for me to see a new day. Lord, I bless your name because I know you love me. I know you care for me. I know my Father in glory because of your care concerning care in my life. That is the reason why I see a day like this. Lord, I appreciate you. Appreciate the Lord because it's good. Blessed Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. We thank you for a new day like this. We thank you for a new hour like this. We thank you for a seconds like this. We thank you for counting us among the living. Lord, we thank you because, my Father, many are dying, many are perished. Forever I am now, it is by your grace. Blessed Father, thank you because you are worthy. Who is like unto thee, my Father? Let your name be glorified because you are worthy to be praised, Lord. For in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, pause a moment and listen. Just pause. Just pause and look around you and think around you. When you check your life, you will find out there are people that was born the same day you was born. Many are no longer alive. When you find out, you find out that there are people that give birth this day you give birth, but many of the children, they are no longer alive. Brethren, when you check of the people that enter Europe, many are no longer alive. Brethren, when you look around, somebody that is alive that can say, oh Lord, I am feeling pain. Brethren, you need to be grateful for the life you are living. No matter the circumstances around you, you need to say, God, I thank you for this trouble of life because I know you are able to see me through. Brethren, you need to look around you. Many have passed away. Many that see yesterday is not all of us that see this morning. Brethren, we need to thank the Lord. We need to understand who is this God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. Wherever I am now, it is by your grace. Many are dying, many are perishing. Wherever we are now, it is by your grace. Thank you, my Father. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Yes, wherever I am now, it is by your grace. Many are dying, many are perishing. Wherever we are now, it is by your grace. Baby, listen to me. Listen to me. Right from the day one, you start joining this group. you find out that the group have the truth, but because you yield yourself to the truth, check your around you. Now, many of you have joy. Many of you have peace. Many of you have understand what is all about Christianity. Why can't you say, Lord, I thank you? Why can't you say, Lord, I am grateful for my husband? Lord, I am grateful for my wife. Lord, I am grateful for my children. Lord, I am grateful for everything you have been doing for me through this group. Why can't you appreciate the name of the Lord? Why can't you say, Lord, I thank you because you are worthy to be prayed. Lord, I thank you for everything that is going on around me because you are aware. Lord, I thank you, my Father, because you are able to deliver me. I know that, Lord, your word is true and your word is yes. Lord, you have promised you never fail. You have promised those that have put their trust in you, they are like a mountain Zion that will never fall. Therefore, Father, in glory, we depend on you. Lord, we hope on you. Lord, we trust on you. We believe on your word. Your word is true, my Father. I am that I am, the Alpha and Omega, the one that seated upon the third heaven, the one that cannot lie, the one that cannot share his glory with any man, the one that cannot fail, my Father, in glory, the one that knows the situation. Oh Lord, my Father, we are passing through. Only you that know the situation. Our Father does not know it. Our mother does not know what is going on in our land. But only you know it, my Father. Only you know all those things that your children are passing through. Lord, I know, my Father, you are able to wipe away the tears. You are able, my Father, to do that which you have promised to do. Because you have promised, my Father, in glory, that we shall know the truth and the truth shall set us free. I know, my Father, that your children are going to be set free for every troubles of life, for every disease of man, for every sickness of life. Lord, I know, my Father, that those troubles will not see the end of us, my Father. We must see the end of those troubles. Blessed Father, I know you are able to do it. Holy Spirit, have your way, my Father, because you are worthy to be prayed, because you are the Father of all spirit. You alone is our Father. You alone is our God. Lord, my Father, your banner over us is love. Glory be unto you. Glory be unto you, my Father. We lift your name higher this morning. We thank you this morning because you are the God of heaven and earth. Lord, you rule the world. You rule the world. The world is in your hands, Father. The world is in your hands. Who is it that can be against us? Where is the witches and wizard? Where is the manje? Where is Onoku? Where is those fake powers, my Father? When you went to the cross of Calvary and you said it is finished, where is those thought power, those forces? Where is the witches and wizard? Why did they not stop you, my Father? Hey, who is it that will stop us, my Father? We are unstoppable because I know, my Father, your word is true. Let your name be glorified. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Let your name be glorified.
In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, let me tell you something. Yesterday night when we was praying marathon prayer, one of my beloved sent me a message at about 1 something a.m. in the night when we was praying. I never knew that they was praying. Praise the Lord. When they was praying, but she sent me a message that a good morning Jesus family never die. That was, we was praying, they was praying on the other side, brethren, just like we are here. They are there praying in another country. Then yesterday I called, I said, were you with me last night in prayer? He said no, that as they was praying, that the spirit ministered to her that good morning Jesus family never die. Brethren, we are going to pray that this group will rob the world. This group will never die. This group must rob the world because Bible said, when there is light, what happened? Darkness disappear. And therefore, darkness must disappear through this group. In the life of people that are having stress of life, the troubles of life that have not been saved, those people that are looking for salvation, that are saying, God, when will you send preacher to me that will preach the raw word of God that I may hear? When are you going to save me? We are going to tell the Lord, this group will never die. Who is, what does it make this group? You and I, we are what that make this group. Therefore, this group will never die. This group must rob the world. Brethren, talk to God this morning. Tell the Lord, this truth must rob the world. The holiness and righteousness must rob the world. The light of God must shine upon men, upon women. Because the devil have tormented men and women for many years. But enough is enough, because this is the last minute. This is the last minute that God is in action. God is at work to raise men and women from nowhere. Oh, blessed Father. Eternal rock of Fiji, immillennial God. Lord, this group never die, because I know you are the one, my Father. You are the foundation of this group. You are the foundation of Good Morning Jesus family. Therefore, Father, in glory, I know, my Father, that you are with us on this group. This group will rob the world. Father, this group must rob the world, because you alone is our Father. We put our trust in you. Father, we ask you to announce this group, my Father, to the four cardinal points of the world. Father, announce this group to rich men. Announce this group to poor men. Announce this group to every man or woman that are seeking for the truth. Lord, my Father, you are the whole world, my Father. Lord, it is not your will for any should perish, Lord, but for all to come to repentance. Those that have not repented, my Father, in glory, that are saying, Lord, when will I hear the word? My Father, in glory, we pray, my Father, this morning, Lord, you will announce this group to them. You will announce the Good Morning Jesus family to them, that they may come and join us, that they may know that this group, my Father, is a special group. Holy Ghost, I pray right now, Jesus, announce your name, that name that is above all principality, that name that is above all name, that name that is above power. Lord, announce that name, my Father, to the world, that they may be saved, my Father, that they may have eternal life. Lord, that they may be saved, my Father. Lord, the enemy have hold them. Lord, the Satan have hold many people captive for many years, but enough is enough. Holy Ghost, I pray, every chain that are holding your children must be broken. Father, that chain must be broken now. That chain must be broken. Every chain of life, every chain of sickness, every chain of poverty, every chain of sorrow, every chain of disappointment, every chain of hindrance, my Father, that be holding your children. Father, that chain, those chains must be broken. Those chains must be destroyed. Every chain of barrenness, every chain, my Father, in glory, of disappointment, last minute failure, those chains must be broken. Wherever where those chains have been coming from, Father, in glory, that chain, is it from the key? Is it from the pit of hell? Father, that chain, my Father, is it Marie Kingdom? Is it from Marie Kingdom? Those chains must be broken, my Father. In the name of Jesus, every name must bow. Father, who is it that can be against us when you are with us? Therefore, Father, I say, my Lord, distance is not a barrier. Distance to Asia is not a barrier. Distance to America is not a barrier. Distance to Africa is not a barrier. Distance to all countries in Europe, my Father, is no barrier. Therefore, Father, you will go and do that which you determined to do. That at the end, men and women will know that this group is for a purpose, is for a mission. This is the group you have decided to use for the last minute war. Holy Ghost, go ahead, my Father, and do that which you have determined to do. For in Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord. Brethren, we are going to pray for our children, that we will not bury our children this year. Our children will not be vagabond. Our children will not be notorious. Our children will be for signs and wonder. Our children, no man or woman can take our children away from us. No government can take our children away from us, because my Bible tells me that I am the children of this group. They are for signs and wonder. Therefore, we are going to pray. We are still going to pray also for one of our sisters that is going to take flight this morning to Africa. We are going to use as a point of contact to all those that will travel today, that the light of God will shine upon them. Brethren, let's begin to pray and tell the Lord to have his way in the life. Oh, blessed Father, eternal rock of ages, immortal redeemer. Lord, I dedicated today into your hands. I dedicated our children to you. I dedicated all the activities of today to you. God the Father, God the Son, I ask you, my Father, to take charge upon the activities of today. I ask you, Lord, to take charge upon our children. I ask you, Lord, my Father, to come down and have your way upon our children. Have your way in the life of our children. Lord, our children will not be buried. Our children, oh Lord, will not be vagabond. Our children will not be wayward children. Our children, your spirit, oh Lord, will unhold our children. Father, you will keep our children going in this world. Lord, you will protect our children. All the obstacles, all the evil spirit working against them, let them be foolish, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, we call on you this morning to come and take primary control upon our sister that are traveling. Lord, keep her going. Lord, protect her. I use her as a point of contact to those that will travel today. Holy Spirit, take primary control upon them. Lord, take over upon all your children. Unhold them. Father, in glory, let your light shine upon them, my Father, so that at the end, all glory and honor will be unto you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Lord, for you are worthy to be prayed. For in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Brethren, this morning we thank God for everything. Now we are about to hear from God. The message we are having before us say, they that hate me love death. That is the message. They that hate me love death. Somebody may be wondering, what is the meaning of this topic? They that hate me love death. Brethren, but the message is going to open your eyes for you to understand that they that hate Jesus, they love death. Those that hate Jesus, they love death. Day before yesterday, I went to evangelism. As in the course of the evangelism, I met a Nigerian man with these people, Jehovah Witness. I told you that do not allow Jehovah Witness people to enter your house. I repeat again. If you allow them to enter your house, brethren, know that you are already on your way to hell. That is the truth of the gospel. Because anybody that contradicts the gospel, that says there is no hell, such a person is Antichrist. I repeat the word again. Therefore, this Nigerian man, I was teaching, this Nigerian man stood up and began to talk rubbish. That, sir, how can it possible that as you are now, you have a child, your child, you love the child so much, and you will send your child will sin against you, you will send the child to hell. It's not possible. You will kill that child. It can't possible. I say these are poor Christians. I begin to analyze to this man, open the eyes of this man, making this man to look into the Bible, see what is written in the Bible. This man said that he don't believe that there is hell, but he believe there is heaven, that they don't believe there is hellfire. Brethren, I say, okay, I shake the young man, I say, good luck. I say, good luck, because I don't waste my time for such people that have concluded with their heart that they will go to hell. I open the Bible, show him many things where he stated about hell. Where he stated that anybody that did not live holy life, where is the person going? It begin to twist the world, that world is not like that. They begin to analyze the world, make the world to become so light to them that they may not fear God. Brethren, I say, well, good luck, young man, Nigeria. You have opportunity. You come to Europe, and you come to Europe now. Instead of you to learn good, you begin to follow the error people. I say, well done. Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, all of you that are hearing me, send this message to all the people you know. Anywhere you see Jehovah's Witness, don't stand with them, because they are teaching fake doctrine, contrary to the will of God, not obeying what is written in the Bible. Brethren, any man or woman, pastors, whosoever, that we preach unto you another gospel, more than this gospel that you are hearing here day by day, holiness and righteousness is the goal. Anybody that contradicts that word, brethren, know that that person is Antichrist. This is the truth of the gospel, and that you need to be afraid. And you need to, if that person enter your house, use broom to sweep that your door. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now we are going to the message that say, they that hate me love death. Turn with me in the book of Proverbs. Please, without wasting time, first reader, Proverbs 20. Let's read from verse 2. Proverbs 20, verse 2. Are we there? Are we there? Please, who is reading there? Nobody to read? Go ahead, Sister Mercy. God bless you.
The fear of a king is as the roaring of a lion. Whoso provoked him to anger sinned against his own soul.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is the word of God. That is the truth of God. Let's go to another place to see. In Proverbs 8:36. Are we there?
Sinned against me. What kept his own soul? All they that hate me love death.
Praise the Lord. That is the word. But him that sinned against me wronged his own soul. All they that hate me do what? Love death. Brethren, those that hate the truth, they love death. Those that hate holiness and righteousness, they love death. Those that hate Christ, they love death. And if you love Christ, you must obey his word. If you love Christ, you must follow his footsteps. If you love Christ, you will never use your life as a selfish interest, because Christ was not so selfish, and you and I must not. Those that hate Jesus, they love death. Anywhere you are, you must to understand that the truth gospel cannot be denied, that the truth is true, that any man or woman that hates Christ, that saying that now the death of Christ is going to be in vain, that person love what? Love death. We are talking about an eternity, everlasting. The death, because Bible said that it is appointed time for a man to die. After death, what happened? Judgment. We are talking about this eternal condemnation of everlasting to everlasting. If I may live in this world, I may live 19 days. 19 days simply mean 19 years. But this year must surely pass away. But if it pass away, where will I spend my eternity? When I hate Jesus. If you hate Jesus, you, who is your father? Satan. And Satan is a bastard, and you don't have father. And anybody that follows Satan, any pastor, any man, even Pope, whosoever, that live contrary to the will of God, that person is a bastard. Just like as I was many years ago, I was a bastard. Why? I was a rebel against the word of God. And for me to follow the truth, I was living contrary to the truth. I knew that what I was doing in those days was not praising God. But I was doing it just because I don't want to suffer. Brethren, glory be to God who have delivered me from that rot. that was about to fall upon me. But today, Jesus Christ, he made this platform to open to every sincere seeker all over the world, that they may remain steadfast on the word of God, that they may not perish, that they may have eternal life, except the person that have determined to perish. But I pray that there will be no one here among us that determined to perish like Judas Iscariot. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Brethren, let's turn our Bible to the book of Proverbs. Proverbs 10:2. Are we there? Proverbs 10:2.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Treasure the wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivered from death.
Are you seeing it now? Treasures of wickedness profited nothing. But what happened? But what? But righteousness delivered from death. Did he tell you miracle? Did he tell you prosperity? Did he tell you prosperity? No. But today, in the churches, many churches today all over the world, what are they telling you? What are they preaching? What are they telling you? Telling you that prosperity, miracle, but look at it. It's a treasure of wickedness. Profit nothing. But righteousness delivered from death. Today, many people are no longer reading the Bible because they are very busy of making money, very busy of looking for one thing another, very busy of in internet, very busy watching television program, very busy attending to meeting one way in another, very busy trying to secure job and all. But what happened? The person does not have time. The person does not have time, 2 hours, 3 hours to go to the Lord in prayer. But that person love what? Love dead. Yeah, that is the reason why he said, the treasure of wickedness. Who are the wicked ones? The pastors. The Christians that are in the church. That are not following the word of God. You can be a pastor for many years. Does not take you to heaven. Are you not saying pastors today are committing the sin of immorality? Those pastors, they hate Jesus. They are mocking Jesus. They are servants of the devil. These people, they love dead. If they didn't repent, the wrath of God will fall upon them. Even Pope, whosoever, that yesterday, a day before yesterday, a man was telling me that he cannot forget the word of the Pope. That Pope was coming from Brazil. They asked Pope, what are you saying about these people, this homosexual, this lesbian? Pope said, who is him to judge these people? That if they love each other, who is he not to stop them? Who is he to stop them? That was his word. Therefore, that word is going to stand against him on judgment day if he didn't revoke that word, because it's contradict to the word of God. Brethren, you need to know that God have no respect of any man, whether big or small, whether rich or poor. The word of God is truth. The word of God cannot be changed. And who any man or woman that changed this word must regret the day that he or she was born. Dear brothers and sisters, truth is the only one that can set you free. Don't be offended when you hear the truth, and the truth must be told. And I have decided, until I die, if you like, take God to kill me, I must speak the word. I must what? Speak the word. If you are with me, glory be to God. If you decide, say no, this man, every day by day, is pointing out my sin, you go away from me, I tell you, the little word you have heard for me will stand against you on judgment day. I pray that you will not be, it will not stand against you on judgment day in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, we need to know that any man or woman that hates the truth, that hates the light, love darkness, and the darkness will punish that person. Because today in the world, Satan is in the world. Satan is doing everything possible, everything to destroy the world, to destroy the souls of mankind, to make the world know that there is no heaven and people are following it. Satan came to this world to steal and to kill. But let's see in the book of John, John 10:10, so that you will understand what is all about Satan. Satan came to steal and to kill and to destroy. Why Jesus came? For you and I to have life and have it abundantly. John 10:10. Are we there? Are we there? John 10:10, are we there?
I have come that they may have life and have they have it more abundantly.
Praise the Lord. It said the thief cometh not, but to do what? But for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But what happened? The Son of Man, Jesus came. I come that they may have life and they may have it abundantly, more abundantly. Brethren, that is the purpose of the Son of Man. Jesus came that you and I may be saved. Just like that day, I was not saved. Just like that day, I was on my way going to hell. I was almost at the door of hell. At the door. I was already there just for them to open the door for me to enter hell. Jesus brought me out of the hell. Jesus brought me out of the pit. Brethren, I tell you that Jesus is available this morning to bring you out of that pit. If only you decide, said no, you look into your life, you really knew yourself, you know the life you are living in America, you know the life you are living in Asia, you know the life you are living in Europe, you know the life you are living in Africa, you tell yourself the truth, no, I will not be perished, I will not perish. You tell yourself, no, I must escape hell. How can you escape her if only you give your life to Christ today? How can you escape her if only you understand what Jesus did here? That the thief come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus came to deliver you from sin. If only you understand that no, I need to return back home. If only you know, no, I need to return back home. Brethren, I was once lost. But glory be to God that I'm now saved. Glory be to God that I'm not talking to you. If somebody told me that, oh, Bartholomew, you are going to be preaching to people all over the world, I will tell the person it's a lie. I never knew that I was born for this purpose because I was at the age of 13 years old when I started looking for money. Brethren, but glory be to God that have bent me. I wish God didn't bend me by now. Satan could have finished me. Brothers and sisters, you need to know that they that hate me love what? Love death. Praise the Lord. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Psalm 49. Psalm 49. Please, let's be fast. Open your Bible. Psalm 49, verse 6. Are we there? Psalm 49, verse 6.
Yes.
Go ahead.
They trust in their words and boast themselves in the multitude of their wealth, of their rich.
Brethren, are you seeing it now? These people, they are going to perish. Who are these people? They that trust in their words. Today, you see many presidents, many people today, able men that are supposed to be thinking of the poor, thinking of Christ. They will rise up. I said, nobody have anything to do with them. They will rise up and say, nah, they are the Alpha and Omega. They will rise up and say, no, you can't do me anything because I have the money. Brethren, those people, what happened? They trusted in their word. They trusted in their word. And boasted their self. In the multitude of their riches because they have this money. But who gave them the privilege is Jesus. Who gave them the life they are living is God. Their life is like a carton. You can put fire carton, that carton blow away at a second. Brethren, the life of every man or woman is like that. You need to know that as a Christian, everything you have, you must not use it to boast in this world. What you should do, you should boast that your name is in the book of life. Not you have this world. You have house in Dubai. You have in America. You have in Asia. You are the person that owns this whole city of Ravenna. No, that is poor Christian. You should boast that, yes, heaven, my name is written in heaven. You should boast that I'm a candidate of heaven. Brethren, that is a great, that is a wonderful riches a man or woman should deserve in this world. That my name is in the book of life. That I have no treasure on this world. My treasure is what is in heaven. Praise the Lord. All those rich men, all those rich women that boasted themselves, that hated the truth. When you see today, even pastor, for them to go there and tell them the truth, what happened? The pastor sold the anointing to them because they cannot tell them the truth. They begin to tell them, sir, we are with you. We are praying for you that it will be well with you. Instead of the pastor to say, thus said the Lord, that if you did not repent, and you will likewise perish. But today is no more. The glory be to God that we have met. Brethren, glory be to God that God have raised us to raise us in this world. That we should preach the word in the whole land, America, Asia, Europe, and Africa. That we should go and tell the people what the coming of the Lord is at hand. Brethren, glory be to God for such a program like this. This is a program that God have determined on that day. When I got a job, God, he told me, said, son, that job, it is, I didn't send you to Europe to come and work. I sent you to Europe to go and preach the gospel. I got the first job, he said, I should reject it. I got the second job, I rejected it. Brethren, why? For the sake of the gospel. Why? For you to know that God is interested of you. For you to know that if you joke with the word you are hearing here, it's going to stand against you. It is a time for you to really look into your life. I have been following this group. I have been on this group. Have I really made up my mind to follow Jesus? Have I really surrendered to him totally? They that hate me love death. Maybe you are hearing the word, but the word you have decided, you have crossed your mind. No. I have decided what to do. Nobody can change my mind. Nobody can convince me. I have decided those things, it doesn't matter. Brethren, these are poor Christians. Yesterday, my pastor, my daddy in the law was telling us the need. Have you ever seen a woman that want to go and see president now? And you want to go and meet with president? How do you used to dress? Can you see a woman wear pants to say she want to go and see president? Can it possible? Or you see all those people that have rasta? They will tell you they want to go and see president. Is it possible? Is it possible? No way. Brethren, is it possible? Eh?
No.
It can't possible. But today, pastor will tell you, even though you wear pants, come to church, you expose your breast is falling, and that pastor is a fire wound. The pastor that stands is iron. And they will tell you it's not a sin at all. Brethren, those people, they do what? They hate the truth and they love death. And you are a woman here, I used to tell you that you are following me and that you are still showcasing your body in social media. Brethren, you love death. I'm telling you the truth. You are not with me. You are not a member of this group. As a member of this group, you must walk, you must be corporate, you must cover yourself. People must know, people must see you that you are not the people in the world. Because Bible says, in the world, but not on the world. You need to know the truth. If you are a woman here, you are oppressing your husband, I tell you, you love death because you hate the truth. You need to know that. You need to know what is written in the Bible. You need to understand what we are talking here, what we are teaching here, that we are making people to know that the need of preparation of heaven. This is a time to prepare your luggage because no more time. Don't, if you love your job more than the truth, you hate Christ. If you love your family more than the truth, more than the Christ, what happened? You love death. I'm telling you. Remember what the Bible said? Whosoever that shall love his father, love his mother, love his children, love his wife more than me, he said that person is not worthy of me. Brethren, who are you as a Christian? Who are you as a somebody that really want to go to heaven? Today, people are securing the property of this world. They are not securing their soul. Have you ever seen somebody that go to supermarket and the person will buy egg and put it inside the wallet? Is it possible? I'm asking a question. Is it possible?
No.
Eh?
No.
Everybody keep quiet. Because am I right? That is the truth. But today in the world, the Christians today, they have put their soul in their pocket. But their soul is more important than the egg. They cannot put egg in their pocket, but now they have put their soul in their wallet because they don't know the value of it. Brethren, such a person love what? Love dead. You need to know that. Let's go to our Bible in the book of Luke. We are rounding up now. Let's read Luke. You need to know what is in the Bible. Luke 12. Let's read. Luke 12, 20 to 21. Luke 12, 20 but to God 21.
But God said unto him, therefore, this night their soul shall be request of thee. Then whoso shall those things be with their heart provided? So is he that laid up treasure for himself and is not rich towards God.
Praise the Lord. Brethren, God said to that fool, this night, because you have boasted, say, who is God? Who is it? Everything in this world, I'm the person in charge. But what happened? God said to that fool, this night, that soul, I require that soul. That soul, I demanded for that soul. That soul, I am taking that soul away. Brethren, do you know that many people slept last night, many people passed away, but nobody could stop that death not to come. That rich man, the soul of that person that is boasting today, I have the treasure in this world. That's your soul. God can require that soul right now. As I'm talking to you now, anything can happen here. Anything can happen. When you hear the sound, when you hear the noise, when you hear the rumors on social media, evangelist, your brother Bartholomew have gone. Your brother that used to speak to you every day by day has gone. People will weep. I know that many people here, they love me so much. Some people will decide not to even eat that because it's going to be a shocking news. Do you know that you cannot hold it? Do you know that you cannot, even though you cry for nothing next year, it can't bring me back again to life? Even though you are with me here, you said, death, don't take Bartholomew, take me. It can't change it. It cannot take you. It cannot take you. It will take me because it has been determined by the owner of my soul. Look at it in verse 21. It says, so is him that laid up treasure for himself and is not what? Is not rich towards God. If you lay treasure for yourself, if you begin to say, now, let me secure the property of this world, let me secure the treasure of this world, such a person is not what? Is not rich towards God. Such a person have no eternal life. Such a person is what? Such a person is going to condemn because that person, that individual, love death. Brethren, this morning, you need to examine yourself. You need to look into your life. As a Christian, who are you? Are you with Jesus or you are with Satan? Brethren, if you hate the truth and you love those things that big pastors are not doing in the church, those bakata, those things, those concussions they are not doing, those fake brethren, those fake doctrine they are not giving you, if you follow it, you love death. I'm telling you the truth. The truth is bitter, but we can't deny the truth. It's only this truth that can set you free from hell. It's only this truth that can give you access to heaven. Brethren, if I don't have document, I cannot from here travel to Germany. I cannot from here travel to America. I cannot from here travel to Africa. The same way, if you don't have your document to heaven, you cannot enter heaven. But the document that heaven requests is what? Is holiness and what? And righteousness. No less, no more. Go and think of it. Go and check from Genesis to Revelation. All what the Bible stated is what? Holiness, righteousness. Bible never described that prosperity or wealth will take you to heaven. Bible never describes this, because it said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and what? And his righteousness. Are you seeing it now? It did not tell you that seek ye first the prosperity and what? And miracle. Did he tell you that? It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and what? And his righteousness. Every other thing shall be added unto your life. Brethren, this is the world. But today, people have changed the world to be sweet from their self. Pastors have not changed the world because they don't want to lose members. Because they want members now to be bringing money to them. Brethren, I tell you, you will regret if you follow those pastors. The truth will set you free. They that hate me love death. They that hate me because I am speaking the truth word of God, they hate Jesus because I am not the one speaking. If you, as I'm speaking right now, I am speaking the word, you told me, you begin to pray, you begin to accuse me, or you begin to say something on my back that I don't know, brethren, I tell you the word is going to stand against you. The truth is true that we can't deny the truth. We cannot. You need to understand that without this holiness, you can't go to heaven. Brethren, bow down right now and meditate about your life. Think about your life. Think about your life. Did I really save? Did I really love Jesus? If you love Jesus, you will not commit sin. Brethren, if you love Jesus, you what? You will not what? You will not commit sin. But they will tell you nobody can escape not to commit sin tomorrow. And maybe tomorrow, no, either tomorrow or next tomorrow, you are going to hear a message. But during this time, since last 2 weeks ago, that Jesus Christ have opened my eyes again to understand that it's no time, I have changed my mind. If you like, you be with me. I have changed my mind to speak the word raw. Are you understanding me? I have repented for my sin. I have repented for my sin. That I must speak the word to you. If I refuse to speak to you, if you die, your blood is upon my head. And for your blood to be upon my head, it's better that I speak the word to you, that you will get offended. That is the truth. Why can't you bow down and think about your life? If it happen now, where will I go? They that hate me love death. Did you hate the truth? Brethren, many of you see the truth on Facebook. You will not share it to other of your friends. You begin to share all those ones. They are saying, miracle, miracle. Those are the things you share on your Facebook. AY show. Those people that are naked, those are the people you share, you comment. The people that preach the truth, you can't share it. Brethren, you need to repent. They that hate me, they love death. If you hate the truth, you love death. Talk to God this morning. Say, Lord, I have heard the word. You have opened my eyes. You have speak to me. You have made me to understand the need, the truth of your word. Lord, as from today, I am repenting for my sin. Talk to God right now. Tell him to help you. Tell him, Lord, I need your helping hand. Lord, helping hand not to hate the truth. Helping hand not to depart away from the truth. Helping hand to remain steadfast on the truth. Helping hand to remain obedient unto your word. Helping hand, I need that helping hand. Cry unto him. The cry you're supposed to cry in hell, why can't you cry unto him this morning? Say, Lord, I need you. Lord, help me because I can't do it. I can't help myself. I have tried my best. I have looked around, but no one could help me. Lord, but this morning, you have opened my eye to understand the truth. I have decided to follow you. Eternal Father, invisible God, the only wise God. Lord, we thank you this morning. We bless your holy name for all you have done. We thank you for making it possible for us to pay attention to your word. Lord, you have spoke to us. Lord, I pray that this word will not stand against me on the last day. I pray that this word will not stand against any man or woman on this group in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take over upon our life. Lord, may Satan never steal this word away from us. Holy Spirit, uphold us, my Father, with your hand. Uphold us, my Father, that we will not fall apart. that we will not depart away from your word, from your truth. Holy Spirit, we need you. Come and take over upon our life, that at the end, we have the cause to glorify. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. For you are worthy to be prayed. For in Jesus' name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. Please let one of our family from London, please conclude this program, if you are there.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, my spirit, demon, we bless your name, we worship you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this great gathering that you have given us, Lord. Father, to hear such a message like this, Lord. Father, because not everybody, Lord, that has this opportunity to hear this word of you. Father, we thank you, Lord, for keeping us, Lord, among the earth, among the world. We are taking you, O Lord, for the love you have for us, O Lord. We appreciate you, O Lord Jesus. Father, for bringing us together to be one family. We have the word of truth, O God, my Father. Lord, we say, may your name be glorified, O God, O Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Here we are, Lord. Lord, we pray, oh Lord. Lord, as we hear this word, oh God, that they that hate Jesus, they love them. Father Lord, you are open our eyes again, Father Lord. We just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Blessed Father Lord, give us the grace, Lord,
yes, Daddy,
to love you and to serve you, oh Lord.
Amen.
The way you want us to serve you.
Amen.
Follow you, Lord.
Amen.
Father, follow you for where you lead them,
yes,
Lord. Father, to follow you all your ways, O Lord Jesus.
Yes, Daddy.
Help us to serve you, O God, my Father.
Amen.
In holiness and righteousness, O Lord.
Amen.
Father, help us, O God, not to depart away from the truth, O God.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we ask, O God, as we hear this word, oh God, my Father, you say, hear the word, oh God, and the word shall set us free.
Yes.
Father God, may your word set us free, oh God, in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
And it's only holy and righteous men that can enter kingdom of God.
Yes.
Father, Lord, I ask, oh Lord Jesus, anything that will take us away from the way of the truth, oh Lord, Father, take those things away from our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I stand also, Lord.
Yeah.
That, oh God, when we know the truth, oh Lord, the truth will set us free.
Amen.
And, oh God, my Father, Lord, that we should seek you first, the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
And every other thing shall be added unto us.
Yes.
My Father, Lord Jesus, we have heard your word.
Yeah.
My Father, I pray, oh Lord, that we should not be deceived, oh Lord.
Yeah.
Father, by any evil prophet.
Yeah.
By any
Amen.
Father, Lord, by Antichrist, oh God, will not be deceived, oh Lord. Because you are God.
Yes.
Father, let your word, my Father.
Yeah.
Keep your word in our hearts, oh God, my
Amen.
Father.
Amen.
Help us to build with your word we have heard,
Amen.
Oh God, my Lord.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Lord, in this word, oh God.
Yeah.
Father, we take us away,
yes.
oh Lord.
Amen.
Because we have decided.
Yes.
Because we have made up our mind, oh
yes,
God.
Daddy.
Father, to serve you
yes.
and to follow you to the end, oh God, my Lord.
Amen.
My Father, no matter the circumstances,
yes.
no matter the troubles,
yes.
no matter the tribulation,
yes.
my Father, help us, Lord.
Yes.
Father, not to come back
Amen.
Because of hardship,
yes.
because of this and that.
Yes.
Father, help us, out, oh Lord.
Amen.
We want to serve you.
Yes.
My Father, we let us.
Amen.
Father, help us, oh God, the end, oh Lord.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Lord,
as me that have heard this word this
yes.
morning, Lord, I pray that you will keep this word in their hearts.
Amen.
Father, help us, Father.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, follow you, O God.
Amen.
To the end, O God.
Amen.
Father, we all, O God, we make it at the end, O God,
Amen.
My Lord.
Amen.
Father, this one will not stand as a judgment before us on that day.
Amen.
Father, On that day, oh God, we don't say, oh, I die, no.
Yes.
Oh, we hear this word from Bartholomew.
Yeah.
But today, see where I find myself.
Yeah.
That will not be our portion in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Oh, so God. Father, to achieve our goal.
Amen.
Father, to complete our mission, oh God, my Father.
Amen.
And to walk to us with no distress, oh God, in our
Amen.
Hearts, oh God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father, help us. God, my Father.
Amen.
Father, to know, oh God, my Father, where you call us, oh God, my
Amen.
Father. Daddy, help us, oh God,
Amen.
My Father.
Amen.
Father, the grace to serve you.
Yes.
Father, to carry on this journey, Father,
yes.
Lord. Father,
yes.
I know the road is so very narrow.
Yes.
I know it's so very rough.
Yes.
But so, Lord Jesus, with you, oh God,
mm.
we are more than conquerors.
Yes.
With you, oh God, Jesus, we have covered.
Yes.
Father, with you, oh God, we will make it,
yes.
oh God.
Yes.
Father, with you, oh God, Father, we will reach the end,
oh,
oh
yes.
Lord.
Oh, yes.
Bless the Father, God. Look unto you. My Father, look unto you, Jesus.
Amen.
Father, heaven is very near to
yes,
us.
Yes.
But looking, oh God, my Father,
mm.
but oh Lord, we need you,
yes.
you, oh Lord, to help us, oh God, in every area of our life, oh God, my
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Oh.
Father, we need that spirit of boldness,
yes.
oh Lord. We need that spirit of more understanding.
Oh, yes.
To understand your scripture,
oh,
to
yes.
understand all oh, your words,
yes,
oh God,
Daddy.
Day and night,
yes,
oh Lord,
Lord,
in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Oh, Amen. Yeah. Thank you,
Jesus,
Father.
For this very morning, oh
Amen.
Lord. We are grateful unto
yes,
you, my
Lord.
Lord.
Yes.
May your name be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we commit your store, oh God,
yeah.
who that I use, oh God, this morning,
yes.
Lord, to speak your word, oh
yes,
God, to
Lord.
Us, oh God, my Father.
Yes,
because,
Lord.
Oh God, in these people, oh God, your servant
yes.
like this, that, oh God, you will use, oh God, to
yes.
speak to us.
Yes.
Father, you can't just go from heaven, oh
yes.
God. Father, speak to us. But
yes.
you use men and women.
Yes.
My Father, thank you, Lord Jesus.
You.
Father, for your son that I use, oh God, this morning. Lord, I pray, oh Lord,
yes,
as he speak your word this
yes,
morning,
yes,
as
Lord.
He speak your word of truth, oh
yes,
God, this
Lord.
Morning,
yes,
my
Lord.
Father, Lord, I pray that you give him more wisdom,
Amen.
More understanding.
Amen.
You will establish him, oh
Amen.
God, my Father,
Amen.
And you will help me, oh God, to fulfill this vision,
Amen.
Oh God, my Father.
Amen.
No power, no demons, oh
Amen.
God. Father, we cut it off, oh
Amen.
God, my Lord, in the
Amen.
Mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Oh.
Father, Lord, I talk back to
yes.
the word in the mighty
Amen.
Name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father,
oh.
help my Father.
Amen.
Father, to achieve his goal, oh
Amen.
Lord, Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting
Thank
Father,
you, Lord.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, Lord Jehovah,
Amen.
God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we commit today activity to everyone's Lord,
Amen.
And then we pray that you lead us through, oh God,
Amen.
My Father.
Because...
And let all we are going to do today, Father,
yes.
Father, let it please you,
Amen.
Oh God, my Father.
Amen.
And in your word said, oh God, that when we, oh God, when we acknowledge you, you
yes.
direct our,
yes.
our
yes.
path.
Yes.
My Father, the Father, direct our path to
Amen.
God. Father, comfort us, oh God, every
Amen.
Area of our life, oh God.
Amen.
Father, so that at the end of the day,
Amen.
All glory and honor
Amen.
Will return back to you, my Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' wonderful day, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My brothers and sisters, we thank God for this beautiful morning God has given to us. It is a time for us to go into the world. Spread the word to your friend, to your brothers and sisters, anywhere they are, that they may be saved. Told you, go ahead, begin to do evangelism. It is a time for us to rob the world. The people in London, in America, Asia, anywhere you are, any country where you are, it is a time to what? To preach the gospel that people may be saved. Praise the Lord. The next program, remember today, Friday, is what? Is our night vigil. Endeavor to be there tonight. Don't miss out. By time is 12 a.m., 12 midnight in the night. Endeavor to be there in Europe time, 12 midnight. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. There will be no live program tonight. The people that join us for their first time, we are grateful to God to have you in our midst. We encourage you to endeavor to download your Zoom if you want to follow us on this group program, so that you can be a part of this family fully. Because we used to start program on time by 5:30 a.m., but sometimes we enter Facebook late because of it is very, very important for you to be following the program on time, so that you will know how the program is going. I pray that the Lord will help all of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, bless and abide with us, now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, may his goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Our life is hidden in Christ Jesus. Jesus is in
God the Father.
Therefore, our life has been saved and secure in the name of Jesus. Our life is hidden in Christ Jesus. Jesus is in God the Father. Therefore, our going out, our coming in, every activities of today, they are safe and secure in the name of Jesus. In the book of Micah 7:7, let's go. Wherefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall rise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me in Jesus' name. May the Lord be a light unto you all in Jesus' name. God bless you all and have a blessed and wonderful weekend.